Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker is now just a little over 2 months away from its official release by writer and director J.J. Abrams and Chris Terrio, as well as creator George Lucas, Disney, and Lucasfilm. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Now, what's really intriguing about Episode 9 is that we do know that this film, at the end of the day, is going to be a very important movie to, of course, the audience, the Star Wars community, if you will, since it really does indeed mark the end of the Skywalker saga and how it's going to serve as the culmination of it all. So, we can already know that J.J. Abrams is trying his very best in order to really create a lot of callbacks to the prequels and the originals to really make this a very authentic Star Wars film. Now, on top of all of this, these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this movie, and when it all comes down to one of the concept art descriptions, this is where things begin to get very intense for Episode 9, involving both Rey and Kylo Ren. Now, specifically, what's really intriguing about all of this is that shot descriptions consisting of a sequence where it's explained that both Rey and Kylo Ren are said to be holding hands, where Rey is described to be holding a Jedi holocron in one hand, where Kylo Ren is holding a Sith holocron in the other hand. This is said to be a moment in which Rey and Kylo are shrouded in darkness, in an environment that mimics the worlds between worlds. It's explained that during the sequence, major revisions of past themes of the franchise are said to be heard and mixed in the background by John Williams, as both Rey and Kylo Ren begin to see a mixture of visions that are meshed together, one of which is said to be of Darth Maul with his double-bladed lightsaber twirling it around from Phantom Menace. Another is actually described to be a vision of Darth Vader igniting his saber from Empire Strikes Back against Luke, where finally another vision meshed with the other two are said to consist of both Luke looking out to a binary sunset from A New Hope, and Vader and Palpatine looking out to the construction of the first Death Star from Episode 3's ending. It's explained that this is Kylo and Rey using the ability called flow walking, which allows them to see visions of the past and of the future at certain points in time. Now, it's described that this sequence is very dreamlike and serves as a test and or challenge for Rey and Kylo Ren by learning elements of the past. So let's go over a couple of parts about this. Now, the thing about Episode 9 so far is that we do know that J.J. Abrams wants to really create a lot of callbacks to the past 8 Star Wars movies that's really gonna bring fans, you know, back to the originals and, of course, the prequels, and to really have that sense of nostalgia in a Star Wars film. And that's the biggest point of all with Episode 9, is that this movie's gonna have a lot of twists and turns related to all of that. So, the one piece that I think a lot of fans want to know more about is, of course, this new ability called flow walking. Now, flow walking was a thing in Star Wars Legends, also known as the Expanded Universe, basically all the books, the comics, the video games that came out after Return of the Jedi, mostly throughout the 1990s and the early 2000s. And with that being said, the fact that they are borrowing elements from Legends is not only a step in the right direction by Disney and Lucasfilm, but it's also a great way to honor George Lucas and his approved ideas back in the 90s and the early 2000s. So this particular scenario, they're actually said to see various visions of course, Darth Maul, Darth Vader, Luke, and of course even Palpatine from various films, ranging from The Phantom Menace to The Empire Strikes Back to A New Hope and Revenge of the Sith. However, these visions are said to be all meshed together into one large vision. Now, that to me sounds different than the normal flow walking technique from, of course, the EU, and that this is Disney's version of all of that. Now, the environment around both Rey and Kylo Ren is said to mimic that of the worlds between worlds, which could very well explain as to why they are shrouded in darkness. You guys may recall when Ezra Bridger was inside of the worlds between worlds in that episode from Star Wars Rebels, is that it was basically him walking on a bridge in space, right? That's exactly what it looked like, with little portals here and there, where he was able to eventually, you know, save Ahsoka Tano from getting killed by Darth Vader. Now, with that being said, this particular scenario is said to not only serve as a challenge for both Rey and Kylo Ren, but it's also said to be a moment in which new Star Wars lore is introduced. We're talking about holocrons, we're talking about new force powers, and we're also tapping into a different realm. Whatever realm this really is that allows Rey and Kylo to witness these visions of the past could either A, be the worlds between worlds, or, you know, it could actually, you know, be something else completely different in design than we have already seen before in, of course, the Star Wars franchise. So, with that being said, guys, I will say that Disney and Lucasfilm, you can already tell that they are really trying their very hardest in order to make this a Star Wars movie that's going to gravitate toward all Star Wars fans, whether you're into the comics, or the books, the novels, or the animated TV series, or just the films alone. This movie is actually said to gravitate toward all fans around the world, of all different mediums of the franchise, which could feel a little, you know, full. It could be a little too, you know, packed in there for a movie like this, but we'll have to wait and see exactly how it's going to be organized and executed once it drops in theaters on December 19th of this year. Anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all this in the comments, and if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.